were the biggest Greek company. And believe it or not, as hard as it is to get to the top, it's even harder to stay on the top. Therefore, being the biggest Greek company gives us a lot of duties as how we should transform the company in order to remain on the top, especially in a sector that is changing extremely quickly. And changing extremely quickly means that nowadays, for many reasons, technological, echoes, habits of the people, economic growth, energy companies have to be transformed as quickly as possible. Our results are good. Our results, I would say, are impressive. And if you see the 9-month results, they're even more impressive. From this, it's the best ever in our history. But this means nothing. This means nothing because it's the international environment which is positive. It is some moves we did, and I will explain to you in more detail in a while, that seem to be correct. It is the very high availability of our process units that give us a margin of money and production that we can cope with. But most important is that we try to exploit the chances in the area. Again, this is stagnant. This is the past. The question is how we go about in the future. Five-year plan means that we have to design today what should be on the market 5 or 10 years later. This is the secret, and I think most oil companies, and very soon you will forget the word oil companies, you will talk about energy companies, try to transform themselves. From our point of view, we know that petrol and fossils in general will be predominant for the next 30 years for sure. Therefore, we don't expect major changes in the oil market. The biggest influence on LNG or natural gas into the energy products will be mainly in the substitution of lignite or all these fossils. So we don't expect major changes from this point of view. But on top of that, if we think of the consumer of the future, if we think of the guy who's going to buy from our retail stations a few years ago later, the products, we know that our thinking is that he will not care much about what will be the basic energy product he's going to buy. He will take his car to the retail station and he will buy electricity, LNG or petrol, depending on the price. His car will be a hybrid kind of car, capable to consume any kind of these products. Therefore, we have to plan it. This is the secret behind our 5-year plan. We have to have all of these products available to our customers. We have to have top quality products. We think that the price of these products will be almost the same worldwide. If I don't say worldwide, for sure in Europe. So the price of LNG or natural gas in Holland, the same as in Spain, the same as in Greece. The price of petroleum products is the same anyway, but will be the same for electricity. Otherwise, you will have trading between the different companies. Everything will be interconnected. From this point of view, Hellenic Petroleum cannot be absent. Hellenic Petroleum has been a strong participant on all these energy products, and this, in fact, explains our 5-year plan. Nowadays, due to the less than expected growth of the economy of India and China, petroleum products, surpluses of petroleum products come to Mediterranean specifically easier than the past due to the new Suez Canal, meaning that we have a very hard competition on any kind of products, meaning that the only way to survive companies like Hellenic Petroleum is to be more competitive, more productive, more efficient. Therefore, techniques, absorption of technologies, logistics, and everything has to be highly optimized in this area as compared to what happens in Northern Europe. Unfortunately, the European Union handles all European refineries with the same aspect. So it's an industry that, allow me to say, is not favorable to the European community. But in order to survive, we have to be competitive, we have to invest a lot of more money, we have to invest on people, on knowledge, on technology that other people don't have to do. This one issue refers to all European countries. And I think the South Europe has to have an answer to that. From this point of view, we are in contact with Fuels Europe. And I was surprised to see that we have a loss of competitiveness of $1 to $2 or even $3 per barrel as compared to the Northern European refineries due to the imports in the area. The second important issue I would like to say is fossils. That's a new issue. The Americans, our friends, are now producing, believe it or not, 2 million barrels per day for export. Shale gas and shale oil. And the price in the market a year ago was around $2 per barrel as compared to Brent, and now it's less than $5, even $7, meaning that the competition in the market, especially the Mediterranean, is growing. These are totally new issues that are heavily influencing the Mediterranean market, and why not the world market? So if we don't take into account, if we don't use this as opportunities in order to be capable to compete the market, you are out of the market. If we do find reserves of oil and gas in the area, it will be a dramatic change overall. And you know why? Europe has a very serious problem on energy security. I can tell you what Winston Churchill mentioned during the First World War. He said that security in energy means diversification of sources of oil. I have to correct Winston Churchill. Nowadays, security means diversification of all kind of energy sources: natural gas, oil, and electricity. And Europe has a very serious problem. Europe has only reserves in the Northern Sea, with the problems of fading out, as you know, Siberia, and the South. So the South corridor of Europe is on the Balkans. So all the projects, all the reserves are here. If this becomes true, then the only alternative source for Europe, apart from Russia, will be from the area. It's important from the geopolitics point of view, it's important from the prospective point of view, and of course from prosperity of the countries. These projects are multi-billion projects, and there's no country, there's no company that can do any kind of projects by itself. I know that everybody speaks about the East Med, but nobody knows about the money involved. It's billions of dollars, and nobody can pay this money by itself. So it's a big, big danger that all these reserves will remain unexploited due to the fact there's a big problem on LNG and gas. You cannot store it. You have to distribute it. The only way to store it is to liquefy and then transfer it and use it. This costs money. Petrol is much easier because you can store it in tanks. Otherwise, so from this point of view, the projects involve the exploitation of natural gas have to be multinational and multi-company. And this imposes by all means cooperation between countries and companies. And I think that all the governments from the Mediterranean, Egypt, Israel, Cyprus and Greece are on the right track, because these projects cannot be done otherwise. We are at the moment very limited on renewables, around 10 megawatts altogether, 8.4 I think, and we doubled it in last month. Our project on the next 3 to 4 years will be to go to 200. Again, this is misleading. because on the overall energy equilibrium of the country, 25%, roughly 25% is the renewables contribution to the energy altogether, to the electrical energy altogether. But in Greece, there are a few things we have to take into account. For example, non-connected islands. To our opinion, instead of giving me numbers how you can grow on renewables, you should stay where you can grow. So it is more ecologically friendly, for example, to produce to on isolated islands totally renewables and provide to these people a really environment-friendly solutions than diesel and mazout, as the fuel oil they are using at the moment. And this is one very important target. From this point of view, we are preparing proposals in order to start with a couple of islands, and we apply to the RAE and to the government and see how we can go about it. The second important issue to mention is technology. Producing energy from renewables, you don't solve any problem. I remind you what happened last January. Last January, what happened was a severe winter. There was no natural gas coming from Russia. The nuclear stations of France were on maintenance. The renewables failed due to the heavy weather conditions. And what happened? The whole system equalized out of hydros, fuel oil mainly, a few renewables, and everything else. So it was the first in history case that all the energy products came to equalize the system. Renewables have a very important issue: how you store it. You produce it on the time that you may not need it. So it's a surplus of energy unless you manage to store it. Everybody's waiting for a technological breakthrough on how you store it. In some islands, you can make small hydros that during the day you can lift up the water and during the night you can bring it down. But batteries is maybe the future, and everybody is, as I said, waiting for that. CSR is part of our DNA. Should be part of our daily routine, daily work. We don't give benefits to the people in the areas we operate because it's a compensation of the operation. No, it's a growth attitude. Let me tell you something. What are the pillars of a successful company? Globalization, co-innovation, competitiveness, and most important, social awareness, which means people. If you think of all these issues I mentioned, in fact, the center of these things is people. The second issue is that Hellenic Petroleum is no more a Greek company. As you mentioned before, we operate in 6 countries in the Balkans. Do we have energy, people and economies in these areas? We don't. We really don't. This is the reason, for example, we gave a scholarship to 19 students from over the Balkans to study energy from its legal point of view, its economic point of view, its technical point of view. So the new generation of people will be the new generation of wise working people who have all the knowledge to handle these complicated issues, because they're very complicated. Believe me, they're very, very complicated. People think you take a ship, you go do the drilling and finito. It's not the case. You have to get all these aspects. In order to do that, you must advertise the importance of the real economy. What is the real economy? It's one who produces benefit to the country, benefit to the people. And I think that our CSR has to get on everything: civilization, sports, social problems, refugee problems, education, on everything that the society needs.